Hi everyone, welcome to WayKen Rapid Manufacturing Channel. I'm Lingo. WayKen has been deeply involved in the CNC machining industry for more than 10 years. In the past years, we have completed tens of thousands of machining projects and inevitably encountered some customer complaints. Today, I would like to share with you an unforgettable customer complaints experience. Let's take a look at the challenges we encountered and how WayKen actively responded and learned from it.
The complaint we received came from the trading company, not the end customer. It's a small batch CNC machining project involving 18 different parts with a total quantity exceeding 8,000. The issue is with a pulley part in the batch. The customer said its dimensions were out of tolerance. At first glance, the part seems pretty simple, but it's actually quite challenging to machine. For most conventional lathe parts, precision can be ensured by machining from a single fixed end. However, this particular part requires machining from both ends, which increases the risk of cumulative error, as can be seen from the 2D drawing. This part has some critical dimensions with very tight geometric tolerances. For example, the flatness of Dayton surfaces A need to be within 0.001 inch, and the total runout for the outer and the B cylindrical surfaces is even stricter as just 0.0005 inch. These ultra-precise requirements definitely make production more challenging. We machined these parts using several precision turning processes, and then shipped it only after confirming it meets the required tolerances. But sometime later, we got feedback from the end customer saying the dimensions were out of tolerance. After comparing their inspection reports with ours, we pinpointed the root cause of the issue. The high precision geometric tolerances of this part presents challenges for inspection. For instance, measuring the parallelism between the small stepped surface and the AN surface is particularly difficult because the stepped surface is only 2 mm wide, leaving little room for measurement points. After testing various approaches, our inspection team ultimately decided to clamp the workpiece as shown and use a customized star-shaped probe for CNM inspection. The total runout inspection is also conducted with the CNM. However, due to the limited access to measurement points during reverse clamping, the workpiece is positioned as shown, and a large diameter probe is used to ensure sufficient clearance while maintaining accuracy.
The end customer doesn't have a Zeiss CNM for inspection. Instead, they use the King's projection measurement equipment to check the circular runout and reported it as out of tolerance. At WayKen, we also have King's projection measurement equipment, but for this dimension, using a CNM is a more practical and accurate choice. The issue arose because we didn't discuss the challenges of measuring geometric tolerances early on. We also failed to align on testing tools and standards before shipment. As a result, there was no shared understanding of the acceptance criteria leading to the return. For WayKen, this isn't a failure, but an opportunity to improve. For small batch projects, conducting FAI is the best approach. It ensures both parties agree on key parameters like measuring dimensions and inspection tools, preventing misunderstandings and ensuring smoother collaboration. That's it for today. Thank you again for joining us, and we hope our sharing helps to build your trust in us. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel and give us a like. See you next time.